8 laps to go in the 500 because, for the most part, their job is done. They have given the car all the service they can possibly give. And now it is up to their driver, in this case, Ari Leijendijk, leading turn the last lap, 217.8. He is flying.
We talked about the ingredients that it takes to win this race. Right now, Bobby Rahal is in a position where what he needs is luck. He can't take it on his own.
Track record is 170.7 miles an hour. That's set in 86 by Rahal. But right now, they're averaging 185 miles an hour. They, of course, means Ari Leijendijk and Team Pearson.
The limit today, Paul, has been the tires. The game plans from all the teams varied tremendously early on in the race. And right now, it's down to two guys. They're racing very hard. It would look like now Ari Leijendijk has an edge.
And last time that a man won here, there's Doug Pearson, the car owner. The last time that a man won his very first champ race here was Graham Hill, who won as a rookie in 1966.
Doug Pearson, who we just looked at, has been directing the strategy. He is a very, very bright businessman. He's a very bright man. And this is obviously a tremendous moment for Pearson because ideas that he has been working on in terms of strategy for several years are now paying off. You see Ari's wife, Miki, they love to collect art, furniture. Their last house near Milwaukee was furnished entirely in white furniture. I don't know whether a $1 million victory here means $1 million worth of white furniture will now be sent out to their new house in California. There she is.
Leijendijk stretches his lead 13 seconds ahead of the second place Bobby Rahal. One lap down is Fittipaldi, who from time to time you can see running. Here you might catch a glimpse of him now on the main straightaway. In fourth place is Allenzer Jr. Rick Mears is in fifth. A.J. Foyt continues to hold on to sixth. Scott Brayton is up to seventh now. Eddie Cheever is in eighth place. 5 laps to go. Rounding out the top 10, ninth place is Kevin Cogan. And 10th place is the 28 car of Canadian rookie Scott Goodyear. Of the Indianapolis 500.
Leijendijk and Pearson, two men whose fortunes in racing have been somewhat held in check because they did not have one thing that they needed, a Chevrolet engine. That is what is making the difference for this team. They finally got the Chevrolet engine, and look at the difference that it's making.
Kind of shows you that the rich and powerful don't always win. This is just the single car team versus the big multi-car teams.
Wayne Sweeney gives the white flag, signaling one more lap to Ari Leijendijk. And Emerson Fittipaldi comes past there, but it doesn't matter to Ari. because Ari is a good 12 seconds out in front of the second place, Bobby Rahal.
Ari Leyendyke, 36 years old, half a lap now from having that monkey of winless streaks off of his back.
What a race to win.
An incredible win it will be, and at an incredible pace. 185.8 miles an hour, his average on the last lap. There's the main straightaway line ahead, and his destiny, Ari Leyendyke, comes for the checkered flag and picks up the win as Ari Leyendyke wins the 74th running of the Indianapolis 500, his very first IndyCar victory. The crew, oh, they're going nuts. Doug Pearson has to be the happiest man on the earth. His car has won the Indianapolis 500. His happiness perhaps rivaled only by this man, Ari Leyendyke. First win for Lola was back in 1966 with Graham Hill, but they've had a tough time showing up at the top of the column at Indy. So Ari Leyendyke has scored his first victory, and it's the most important victory you can score, the Indianapolis 500-mile race. In just a few moments, we'll join Ari Leyendyke in victory lane at the Indianapolis 500.
Three, the Dutchman takes the customary swig of milk. Doug Shearson giving him the congratulations. Ari Leyendyke, welcome to the Indianapolis 500 victory lane.
I think it's a dream. I don't know what's happening. It's unbelievable.
It all happened so quick. You qualified on the outside of that front row. You did so very well. And then all during the practice, you kept saying to us, watch us in the race. And the race came to you today.
It certainly did. I just hung in there at the beginning. We had some push, and the guys did a great job. They cured the handling, and at the end of the race, when it counted, the car was just beautiful. And I have to thank all the guys of my team, Doug Shearson.
Hey, most people come into victory lane and they're soaking wet and perspired. Your hair's just a little wet, but you don't even seem like this was much of a 500-mile contest for you.
No, this is the hard work right here. I mean, this is getting, I can't believe this is happening. I'd like to say hi to my parents out there. They're watching in Holland. I'm sure they're proud. And my wife's parents, Mika.
Hey, average speed, a new record, 185 miles an hour. Your name goes in the record book as the fastest 500-mile race winner ever.
Well, I don't care if we were doing 60 miles an hour average. We still got first place, and that was count. This is unbelievable.
When you came down and took the checkered flag, what was it? Was it an emotional moment? Was it a moment that you thought about, or was it just business as usual?
I was trying to keep myself together. We had 25 laps to go, and I said, you know, just treat this like anything else out there. Don't let it get to your head. And I was real calm, and there wasn't any problem. And I actually thought I had one more to go. So when I saw the checker, I just kind of went nuts in my helmet.
Well, Doug Shearson, you have waited to come to victory lane for a long time. Drivers like Danny Sullivan, Al Unser Jr., they've been at the wheel. And now Ari Leyendyke has done it for you.
We've been close before, but I think I've told you all month we came here to win this race. And we were prepared from the first day we went on the track. I'm really proud of the whole team. I mean, this is absolutely fantastic. You know, what's really nice is waking up tomorrow morning with no excuses. I'd just like to say hello to my mom and all the people back in Adrian, Michigan. We did it.
For the first time since Graham Hill came here as a rookie and came home victorious, Mika, your husband is a 500-mile champion. How does it feel to you?
It feels fantastic to me. Same as it feels to him, I guess.
Any long-distance phone calls back to Holland tonight?
Oh, yes, for sure. Yes.
Back up a little bit. Oops.
Yep. It is sheer pandemonium here, Paul Page, and rightfully so. First-time winner in the Indianapolis 500, and his name will go on that BorgWarner trophy. Let's go back to you.
And he shattered Bobby Rahal's track record by 15 miles an hour. There's still great racing action coming up later today on ABC Sports, the International Race of Champions. And then we'll take you across the sea to Monte Carlo. But we'll be back with more from Indianapolis.